So today we are presenting a Power Automate demo training. Truly, I'm a Microsoft technology consultant with more than 5 years of successful experience in various Microsoft products with expertise in Power Platform, that is Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, and Power Virtual Agents, along with Office 365 and SharePoint development. My strengths are SharePoint Online 2016, 2013, and other Microsoft projects, products such as Microsoft 365, Dynamics 365, Azure, and .NET. Also, I'm a Microsoft certified Power Platform Consultant, Power Apps Maker, Solution Associate, and Solutions Developer. So today's agenda here is that we are going to give you an live interactive session on Microsoft Power Automate. So what is Power Automate? In brief sense, if we talk about Power Automate, is a service that helps you create automated workflows between your favorite applications and services to synchronize files, get notifications, collect data, and many more functionalities provided. Now, what can we expect from Power Automate? There are a few of the examples that we can achieve through Power Automate. It helps you automate business processes. It helps you send automatic reminders for past due tasks. It helps business move data between systems on a schedule. So on a particular schedule, let's say a daily, weekly, or a monthly schedule, at a particular time, data can be moved from one system to another and back and forth. Power Automate gives almost around 300 data sources to be connected either publicly or through a web API. And even one can use data connectors to connect data from Facebook and Twitter along with many other data sources. Now, Power Automate also helps automate tasks on a local computer, like computing data on an Excel sheet. So these are few of the basic functionalities that Microsoft Power Automate tool provides. In this training course, we are following a curriculum. So the curriculum starts with a basic knowledge, a basic know-how about Power Automate, and then about types of flows that can be created using Power Automate, then creating a first flow, a basic flow using Power Automate, using different connectors and actions in Power Automate. As I mentioned earlier, there are more than 300 types of connectors that can be used. So we'll be leveraging some of the basic connectors such as SharePoint, Microsoft Dataverse, Azure SQL, Oracle SQL, and many others for real life examples. We'll be also building multiple complex flows using Power Automate. We will be creating a business process workflows, BPF, which are used in alongside with model-driven applications and Power Apps. We'll be also integrating Power Automate workflows with Power Apps and SharePoint, which is a very, very basic and a very important requirement going around these days with Power Automate. We'll be showing how to import and export flows in different environments in Power Automate. Every organization has different environments, let's say development, testing, and production. So we'll be showing the ways to import and export workflows from one environment to another so that the time taken to deploy workflows is less. We will be giving an overview of Power Platform Admin Center, where you can create policies, you can create environment for creating Power Automate workflows. We'll be integrating Power Automate tools with Microsoft Teams, which is a very widely used tool these days, Microsoft Teams, for communicating within an organization. So we'll be doing that. And lastly, we'll be creating Power Automate workflows using AI builder capabilities, as Microsoft is also working extensively with the robotic process automation, that is RPA, and they have provided many AI capabilities for text recognition, form processing, and many others as AI capabilities into Power Automate. So this is the course curriculum for this training. And this course will be of approximately 22 hours of duration, and this will be provided by specifically by MindMagix, and all the fee related questions need to be connected MindMagix team. So many of you might ask, what is the use of Power Automate and what is the need of learning Power Automate? So in basic sense, the world is gradually moving into the automation and cloud computing, and all the manual tasks and all the tasks that were done using either paper-based task or Excel-based task are now being very steadily and very swiftly being done using automated tools. So due to this, the rapid change in the organization structure, Power Automate comes as a very good tool to automate all the manual processes, to automate all the business processes that used to take a lot of time, and that is being automated using Power Automate. So as of now, as per a recent market study, more than 7,000 companies all over the world are using Power Automate, and that has grown at a rate of 50% in the last 1 year. So this is a very, very widely used tool these days. And as per our research, an average salary for a Microsoft Power Automate expert in India today is within the range of 12 to 15 lakhs per annum. And if you consider in US, it is almost 80,000 to 1 lakh USD per annum. Now, there are many companies, if you go through Power Automate site, which I'll be providing later, the Microsoft site, many companies are specifically partnered with Microsoft using Power Automate capabilities, and few of the companies are hiring directly Power Automate experts such as KPMG, PwC, Deloitte, Ernst & Young, TCS, Accenture, Infosys, and many others that are certified gold and platinum partners of Power Automate to Microsoft. Once you are done with the Power Automate training and you feel comfortable working in Power Automate, so there are different courses, Microsoft certifications that one can go through after completing this course, after completing this training. So there are currently five available certifications by Microsoft in the market for Power Automate experts. They are PL900, PL100, PL200, and 400. So as you go along, these the expertise level of this certification increases. And recently, there is a PL600 Power Platform Solution Architect certification launched by Microsoft, which is in the beta version. So one can also go for that if they feel comfortable with it. After completion of this training, MindMagix will provide you a course completion certification, which you can use in your professional profiles in LinkedIn and Naukri. And this is a very good certificate of achievement that you have completed this course. And this is a very widely recognized certification all around the industry here. So it's a very good certification to have. In Power Automate training, so I'll be going with an overview of cloud flows today. So there are three types of cloud flows: automated flows, instant flows, and scheduled flows. So automated flows are something that are automating a process. Let's say some item is created in a SharePoint list or modified. So the flow runs, and then it performs a particular task, let's say sending an email or creating a content in a different library. So these are automated flows. And instant flows are something that require a trigger and they work instantly. A trigger can be a message on MS Teams or an email in Outlook. So that can work as a trigger, and these workflows start with a trigger instantly and then work according to the actions stored in the workflow. And scheduled workflows. So scheduled workflows are recurrent workflows that recur at a particular time of your choose. So you have to schedule a particular time when a workflow runs. For example, if you want to send an email daily to a particular person to fill his or her timesheet, so you can schedule this workflow to run at, let's say, 9 a.m. every morning. And that workflow will run at 9 a.m. every morning, and an email will be triggered to a particular person to fill their timesheet before they start working. If you have to work with cloud flows, so there is something called trigger that is required to start a workflow. A trigger is something, it's an event that starts a cloud flow. For example, if you want to get notification in Microsoft Teams when someone sends you an email, in this case you receive an email is a trigger that starts the flow. So this is a basic concept of trigger. We'll be going with the more detailed version later on. So during the course of this training, we'll be working on few projects also. So a project will start. The first project will be creating a first Power Automate workflow that will send an email when a new item is created or modified in a SharePoint list. So that will be a basic workflow, a first workflow to start with. Then there will be a second project where a Power Automate schedule flow will work to send an email to fill the timesheet. Also, a schedule workflow will run to pull data from OneDrive and push it into SharePoint list or library. So there will be two scheduler flows that we will be creating. Then third project will be a somewhat a complex of workflow and Power Automate approval workflow for approval processes that involves multiple stakeholders. So this is a very common requirement in organization, and this is somewhat of a complex workflow that we'll be creating using different connectors and different templates that are provided by Microsoft and Power Automate. And we'll be creating a process that would be requiring approval from multiple people. So we'll be seeing various scenarios. Let's say if one person approves and another rejects, then what will happen? If all approval is required or not? So this will be our third project. And our last project will be creating Power Automate workflows using AI builder capabilities. So we'll be using text recognition, form processing, and category classification capabilities to check the sentiment of our message. Let's say if I type a message on my dashboard, "Hi, I'm feeling good." So it will provide us that today I'm feeling happy, or let's say, "Hi, I'm not well." So it will provide me a sentiment that I'm not feeling good today. So this will be a nice way to check the AI builder capabilities in Power Automate. Now, for us to work on Power Automate, we have to set up a lab for that. And the prerequisites for setting up a lab will be requiring a Gmail account. That can be a work or a school account. I would rather prefer you to go with a personal Gmail account and a Windows device, which will require your administrator privileges. And then at least 2 GB of storage and 4 GB of RAM is minimum is 1 GB and 2 GB, but I would recommend you to have a storage of 2 GB and RAM of 4 GB. So one can create a 30-day trial in Office 365 and free trial, and that can help you to leverage Power Automate, and it will provide you an E3 license. So I'll show you how to create a free trial account in Power Automate as well. Now there are some additional courses that you can go through while attending this training session. There are a couple of Microsoft documentations that are provided in Microsoft site. I will provide you a link for that. So it's a very, very conceptual guidelines of what is Power Automate, how to work in Power Automate, and it's a very detailed perspective. So one should go through it. It's completely written by Microsoft experts and people who are working with Microsoft. Also, there's a YouTube channel for Power Automate. I'll share the link. And then there's a site, flow.microsoft.com, that provides you blog with Power Automate. So that is also Microsoft blogs. So you can go through that as well. Now, after we are done with this training, there will be a mock interview that I'll be conducting with all of you guys. So I'll be asking standard industry questions on Power Automate that are asked mostly in all the interviews around the world. And these are very basic questions, and these are very important questions with Power Automate. And these questions can help you land a dream job in any company you would want. After the training, if you have any questions, there is a questionnaire that I'll be sharing. You can drop in your questions with that. Also, you can feel free to drop an email to info@mindmagics.com for all the questions. I'll be happy to answer all your queries. I'll be showing some demos of Power Automate workflows. So I want you to go through it, and this will be a very nice session. Yeah. So let me show. What Power Automate looks like. So this is the Office 365 tenant that we have. And in this tenant, we have all the applications that are provided in Office 365. We have to use Power Automate here. So we'll open this. Now, one thing that one should notice every time you open a Power Automate site, now, I have registered my account, the Office 5 account in India, so it will show india.flow.microsoft.com. If someone in US is using the tenant, has registered in a US domain, so it will show us.flow.microsoft.com, and so on and so forth with each and every country. So it is particularly built for each country here. Now, This is a list navigation menu that remains the same for every account. There are action items that I'll be showing how to go through. These are my flows that shows the flows that I have created right entirely. Now this is a create, I'll come to it. Now these are connectors that I was telling about earlier. More than 300 connectors are provided. This is a popular connectors here. You can go through it. All there's a list of entire connectors, and some of them are premium connectors. Now, what premium connectors mean is that there are two types of licenses in Office 365, that an E3 license and an E5 license. So for trial, you'll get only E3 license, but some organizations also use E5 license, that is a business premium license, and it's more costly than E3. So it has all these premium connectors as well, free of cost. Now, if you are using E3 license, since it is a trial, so these connectors are available to me at free of cost. But had it not been a trial account, then all these licenses would have been bearing some cost for me to use. So this is one thing that you have to go through, and I'll show how to use premium connectors as well. This is the data. This is something called Microsoft Dataverse that I'll be coming back to later. Now, as of now, let's talk about flows. So if we come to my flows, now there are three types of flows here: cloud, desktop, and business process flow. So today we're working with cloud flows. Now there are three types of cloud flows as well: instant, scheduled, automated instant, and scheduled. So let's go with a scheduled cloud flow. When you click on schedule cloud flow, you have to provide this a name. Let's provide this a name. Now here you have to schedule a time when to run this workflow. So I'll be scheduling it today at 7 p.m. Now repeat every, I would say every day. You can choose month, week, day, hour, minute, second. I would choose every day. Now you create this workflow. Now you see it is running every day. Now you edit on it. It's running every day. Show advanced option. Always go through advanced option. This is a very, very good practice to know what are other options available here. All right. Now if you noticed, I have given a 7 p.m. time zone, but it is showing me a 1:30 time zone. So this is important for you to know. Why it is showing 1:30? Because it is following a GMT time zone. So 1:30 p.m. in GMT means 7 p.m. in IST. So if you want to change the time zone, you can select time zones here, and then you can set a scheduled time here. But as of now, I have chosen 7 p.m. So 1:30 p.m. seems perfectly fine for me. Now I'll be going with a new step. Now what I have chosen a time at 7 p.m. Now what I want to do at 7 p.m. that is something important here. Now there can be many things. Let's say I want to have an email, send me an email. Now I will choose two. Now here I can select the users who I want to send an email. I will select myself. Now one thing you have to notice here, you can only use the users that are there in the Office 365 tenant. Now, what do I mean by Office 365 tenant? Now, this is my Office 365 admin center, and these are the users that are available in the Office 365 admin center. So I can only add from these users. I cannot add a user that is not available there. So for you to add a user, it should be available in the list here. So this is important. Now I would be emailing me and a user that is there. Now then I have to add a subject, attend meeting. And I will be sending an email. Please attend the meeting. I will be saving this slow okay, so I will change the name, save. Now here is a flow checker that if it is 0 and 0, then your flow is perfectly fine. Now I have to test a flow, then manually I will test it. I will run a flow and I have got an email. Same email I have got in my other ID as well that I have used. Please attend the meeting. Now, if you notice, all these emails are triggered by this email ID, microsoft@powerapps.com. So this is a Microsoft ID that sends you an email. So these are like alerts that Microsoft is sending you. This is something of a basic example of a flow that we can create. This is a very basic example. I just wanted to let you guys know how workflows work here. Now, there is a workflow that I have created that is an instant workflow. So I want to show this workflow as well. So what is this workflow doing? Now, this workflow is converting a PDF document, a Word document, sorry, to a PDF document. So how it is doing, that is an important thing that I want to show here. So this is my source library and this will be my destination library. So what I'm doing here, I am getting the properties in a SharePoint from a share. This is a SharePoint list. And when I upload a document, a Word document here, I'm getting all the properties for that. And this is a site address and a library name that I have to give here, the source library name and a site name, advanced options. Now, the top count is important because it by default it only takes 100 values. Now we are putting 1000, so it will take 1000 values. Now what I'm doing, I'm getting the file content here using an identifier. This identifier is a dynamic content, SharePoint file identifier, and the site address is given here. I'll be creating a file in Microsoft OneDrive. This is another action in a connector that we are using. We'll be giving it a name. And we'll be using the file content here. Now I'll be converting the file using the ID, and in OneDrive it gives you an option to convert into PDF, HTML, JPG, and GLB format. And then we'll be creating this file in the destination library and deleting it from OneDrive and SharePoint. So I'll be showing in detail how it works. As of now, it is just I'm giving a preview of this workflow, that an instant flow, that how we can trigger an instant flow in Power Automate. So I think that is it from my end today. I've given you an example of three types of cloud flows: instant, schedule, and trigger workflows. So thank you everyone, and thank you for this interactive session, and I hope this thing is clear to you about Power Automate, and I'll be looking forward to see you guys with your questions and with some new topics on Power Automate tomorrow. And I appreciate your feedback, and this will help us to improve in delivering quantitative trainings further. Thank you guys.